Hello gamers, and welcome to Let's Try The Keep. It's an old school dungeon crawler with real-time combat by a Czech developer Cinemax, based in Prague. The game has actually been released in 2014 already, 11th of September 2014, for the 3DS. Now, this is not the 3DS version, it's been ported to the PC, and we're going to take a look at it. In the description, back in the days, it said, "The idea behind The Keep is very simple, to bring the essence and dark atmosphere of RPGs from the past to a new platform, with touchscreen-based controls for newcomers and fans of the genre alike." So we will see how that transports to the PC. In The Keep, you will embark on a quest to explore caves and mines filled with monsters to be slain and puzzles to solve underneath and surrounding tower of evil sorcerer. It won't be easy, you will die a lot. The Keep has been in development for more than 24 months, and there's a simple reason for it. Cinemax are trying to pour all their love for old school games into the game and proving themselves that they were wrong, saying after the release of The Inquisitor, "We will never ever make an RPG game ever again." So, let's see what we can do. We've got options: English, German, French, Italian, Spanish, Portuguese. That might be whatever, possibly Czech. English? Okay. Let's start. Profile, okay, we've got A, B, C, D, E. Let's go with A. Start game. Difficulty, well, let's go for normal. Permadeath, yes. Skip tutorial, no. Without permadeath, you know, it's less thrilling. But if it says we die a lot and then we play with permadeath, it might be kind of detrimental for the runs. That looks quite nice. Okay, I move forward.
There's a button on the left wall. Push it to open the gate.
Okay. Say button on the left wall. That's the button, okay. Mount the cursor changes. And you move in 90 degree steps, so it's not like fully 3D. It's traditional tile based.
Approach it and read it. Take a stone from the floor and place it in your inventory, then throw it through the bars. When throwing items, the height and speed of the slide affects the throw's distance.
Okay. That take a stone, right? Okay, there's the stone. Let's take it. We have to throw it through the bars, but why? Exactly. Ah, because there's a pressure plate. Can I get rid of that again? Okay, I can move mouse-based, also with the cursors, and I can sidestep, which I can possibly. Yes, if I play with, and that's A, that's D, and you turn with Q and E. Let's take the stone if we can.
Take the torch from the wall and equip it to your right hand slot so that you can use it as a weapon. You can hold it in your left hand as well, but it will only be used as a light source.
Okay. Okay, okay. There's a compass. We need the compass for sure. Let's take the stone. Now we have to take the torch. Let's put it into our right hand. Torch comes in handy in dark dungeons. It can also be used as a weapon. It deals 5 to 11 physical damage per 13 stamina. How do we attack? Not sure. Equip mode. Combat mode.
Don't forget that different kinds of opponents have different armor for their different hit zones. Some cannot be hit in certain hit zones at all.
Okay. That's interesting. Hit zones.
Switch to combat mode and hit the sack with an attack in the correct hit zone.
Okay. Combat mode? Or just click on the sack, I guess. This is the mode where you use when attacking enemies, slide across all three squares horizontally or diagonally to perform a standard attack. If a combo part is available, follow the pattern to execute a combo attack. Okay. I see. Interesting. Okay.
Now fight the rat with your standard attacks.
Okay. Let's do that. So we can attack like this. Or this. Or this. But not in the middle, up and down. Just diagonally. Or horizontally. On different levels. So let's move forward and attack. Can I move it in here as well? Yes, I can. That's good.
Equip the dagger and use it to charge a combo point while fighting more rats. Then perform a combo attack.
Okay, let's take the dagger. Use the torch as a light source. I want to get rid of this thing, actually. Okay. Oh, I need to do the combo attack. I see. Okay. I think I didn't do it correctly. Let's try again. There we go. I can only do it when it's charged. See what we've got here. Nothing we can do. Nothing we can do, apparently.
Take the runes from the ground and place them in your magic matrix.
Oh, magic matrix.
Tap the casting mode button to lock and unlock the matrix. Runes can only be arranged while the matrix is unlocked. Spells can only be cast while the matrix is locked.
Okay. Rune of fire, rune of levitation, and rune of injury. How can I lock it? In this mode you can cast your spells. First, you have to find a scroll and learn the incantation. Then you have to move the appropriate runes to the magic matrix and slide across them to cast the spell. It's quite interesting. Now it's locked. Okay. Oh yeah, I can remove that thing. That's good.
Take the scroll from the niche.
Okay.
Read it, arrange the runes accordingly, and cast the spell.
And this is all real time. That's a bit scary. Scroll of fireball. Hurls a fiery ball that deals 15 to 25 fire damage. Some enemies are more vulnerable to fire while others are immune to this element. Okay, so it's injury, fire, and... This one is casting mode. Casting mode. You know, I don't know how this one is called. It's called levitation, interestingly. But this should do it. Oh, nice.
Take the potions. Notice how the same type of items can be
Can stack in the inventory. Where's our inventory? Tutorial dungeon, there's our inventory. I can't take it because... Okay, can I use... I can use the numpads. So one is combat mode, two, three is the map, four is equip. 5 is equipment, 6 is directions, 7 is options. Okay. Now let's take this.
In the mines, you will come across magic crystals that can also be placed in a magic matrix. Mm-hmm. Spells do more damage when used as part of an attack spell incantation, particularly to magic users.
Mm-hmm.
Remember that some creatures are resistant to certain magic elements such as fire, frost. There is much more to see and learn in the keep. Go now and fight your...
Okay, what can we do with the crystals right now? I mean, do we use them up? All runes contain a piece of a magic crystal. You can improve any fire, frost, or lightning by adding a crystal to the incantation. We could actually... You know, let's put one here. No. Let's put it here. Put it like this, maybe. And then... Okay, we can't go through. Can we hit it? Yes, we can. Can we cast a spell? Oops, I need to lock it. And we've still got the crystal. Resisted. Oh no, we don't. It actually used the crystal. That's too bad. Let's keep that for tough opponents. We've wasted some crystals but learned a lesson.
It's a funny thing about rumors. They begin life as harmless stories, but with enough time and denying from those involved, they can grow to bring down empires. And so it was that when word began to spread that a nefarious wizard had come to power near the village of Talia, the High Council did the worst thing it could. It did nothing. It denied everything. And when no scouts returned from the region, it was not long before the common folk began to question the High Council's ability to deal with the situation, its competence to rule the Empire. And where the High Council failed, others stepped in. Heroic soldiers traveled to Talia to slay the wizard. Criminals fled there to escape the law of the realm. None were ever seen again. So it was that when this young man entered Talia, his future looked rather bleak.
Hmm. Oh, we've got skill points. Character stats. Shall we go more for strength, intelligence, or dexterity? Intelligence determines your mana and the power of your spells. Strength determines your health and the power of your attacks. I couldn't give myself a name, unfortunately. And dexterity determines your stamina and allows you to regenerate health faster. That's interesting. Well, let's focus on magic. I can't undo it. We don't have any equipment left. Now this is the proper start. Okay. Can we take the torch? We'll see. Can I take the torch? Yes, I can. Can I take the candles? No, I can't. Can I open this door? Yes, I can with the lever. There's a stone on the pressure plate. There's another stone. Let's take the stone. Oh, I've been under attack? Or did I just fall? I think I just fell. Let's take a look at the map. Huh. It was a trapdoor. Oops. Okay, you have to throw it with force. Let's continue this way first. It's good that we've got this auto map. Now this is gonna be tricky. What is going to happen if I remove that stone? Possibly this will miss another trapdoor. More trapdoors. There's a torch. If I take the torch... nothing happens. So I can actually go here. Oh no, look at this. It's for the door. Okay. Another torch. Oh no. I'm standing on this thing. I have to be careful. I think we can take this torch. Okay. I like the soundtrack. Quite obviously they've done something to the graphics. It's not not the same as on the 3DS, quite obviously. I'm playing on highest settings. Can I hit this? This opens the door. Can I interact with this? No. Okay. How to open this? Another look at the map. Maybe it has to do with this pressure plate. Not sure. This means I've got light, I guess. Huh. Let's just open this one. Ah, okay. There simply was another lever. I could have kept the torch. There's a silver key. Let's see if it fits. It does. Okay, this would have been locked. But let's be safe. Rather than sorry, not to miss anything. I really like the map. Okay. There's a crystal. Secret discovered. We don't have any magic runes yet, though. Okay, this is a trick thing. This is another pressure plate. I can move through though. Okay. Let's take the stone. It's a bit like Legend of Grimrock, where you need this, you know, stones and stuff. Quite obviously this is an inspiration, and I've died. I do not know why. Restart level, yes.
It's a funny thing. And when... And
Chapter 1 tower entrance. We did not get very far. But we continue playing with permadeath. I want to see if I can make it to... Okay, there's... Let's take this stone and go down. It's actually nothing, apparently. Unspent attribute points. Okay, let's go more for strength and dexterity this time. We are level 1. We have not fought a single opponent yet. Let's not take too much stuff. Take this torch. Is there maybe a secret? Clicking? No, apparently not. Okay. Oh yeah, I've forgotten. This other lever right here. Let's go this way and see that there's nothing. Let's go this way. Take the silver key. And oh. Okay, I have to be closer. Which is kind of logical, actually. Let's see if we can take some stuff again. I'm not an expert on this type of dungeon crawlers. For now, of me and I, we are recording a podcast. Well, it's actually his podcast, and it's in German Spielwiese podcast. And I'm like a regular panelist. And we've got a special series on computer role-playing games starting in 1979. So far, we've done one podcast on 1979 till 85, and then 86 to 87, and just released a third one on 1988. And I kind of started my role-playing games, you know, with those bird perspective games like Ultima, or later on the German role-playing games, how are they called? The Northland trilogy.
No matter how many of you die in here, more keep on coming.
Realms of Akania, it's called.
It's courage, tenacity. No.
I've also played
Might
and Magic 5.
Stupidity.
But so I'm not an expert on this type of dungeon crawling game.
So you're the hero, with no interest in crystals or my knowledge, just a noble urge to save the world. But you know what? I like that. We, my dear hero, are going to have a little chat before you die. I'm a little preoccupied right now, but there's a perfect place where you can wait.
So we've met the antagonist, Chapter 2 Prison. And I believe that permadeath means we can restart at level in Chapter 2, hopefully. I'm a bit surprised.
There's one good thing about prison. It really gives you time to think, and I think that I should have handled my encounter with Watrys a little better.
Oh.
Not being thrown in a prison would have definitely been a better outcome. Yes, I underestimated him, but he's done the same with me. I've been bruised, battered, and burned by spells. I've been beaten and left for dead, and I've seen the inside of a prison before, but I'm still alive. You've had your turn, Watrys. Now it's mine.
Yeah. I mean, we didn't start with any, like, sword or something. But we would have lost it anyway, I presume. Is there anything hidden here? No. Yet again, another soundtrack. I can't click this guy. Oh. I can possibly destroy the bed? No, I can't. It could deal very little damage.
I need to find and equip a weapon to defeat that guard. Perhaps that torch will do.
But I could destroy it with my bare fists. This torch will definitely do. Let's equip. Oh, that was good. I could slide it just over here. So it's good. Can we sneak or something? I don't think so. Holy shit. Okay, there we go. Oh, that's very stressful. Oops, stamina potion. There's a lever. And a key. So we can possibly open the... Yeah, we can. Now the guard has vanished. So no cops is lying around. Okay, there's a rat somewhere. Let's go for the map. There's a stone. Not sure if we can get there. Maybe with this. Yes. Our stamina. So it needs to recharge, so I might have to run away once in a while.
Freedom.
Yeah, not for you, my dear.
Freedom.
I think it's not called freedom, I think it's called freedom. Freedom. Okay. This appears to be nothing here. Let's check the other segments first. What do we have here?
Push the button to call the watch.
Okay. So... I do not really want to do that. Okay, there's another rat. Prepare for battle. Reach, move... Okay. Move back, attack. Hit and run. Very good. Okay, that's fun. Not too stressful after all. Okay, minor healing potion, nice. Okay, there's another torch. I don't know if there are like secrets if I click on walls or something. I think my guess is only if there's an indication. But you never know. I need to push the button. Okay, he's coming. There we go. Okay, need to mind my stamina. Okay, well, that's interesting. Because he's got the shield, it might be better to hit his legs. Oh, and we've got a dagger. Now then. Okay, we can only equip it here. Let's equip it here. 911 physical damage per 14. Yeah, that's significantly better.
Cellar.
Cellar, okay. Do we actually gain XP? Yes, we do. From killing enemies, rescuing children, like in Too Dark, another game I've kind of let's tried. It's a horror game, horror action stealth adventure by the creator of Alone in the Dark. So check it out on my channel, Let's Try Too Dark. Available for Xbox, PS4 and PC. I did play the Xbox version. Enough advertisement.
Exit.
Exit? Okay. So we need a key. Where do we get the key? Reception. Reception might have the key. Oh! Not good. How many guards? Two. Not good. Combat ready? Okay, there we go. Okay, I can do a special attack. I failed. Okay, that was good. I think the special... Oh, melee skill leveled up. Learning by doing. I think this kind of retreating is really necessary. We've got lots of health. We are actually regenerating health. And we've got the silver key. Fantastic. Let's take another look at the map. Okay, it was in this room, I think. Okay. Very nice with the tile-based things. Yeah, we definitely regenerate health.
Warehouse doors are closed for security reasons.
Rats. Oh, there's a rune of injury. And there's a scroll. Oh, very nice. Scroll of fireball. Okay, we still lack lots of stuff to actually cast a spell. Okay. Maybe in here. Oh, yes. I think it was like this, right? There we go. And then it's a, like a timer.
Return the exit. Return the exit.
Yeah, I won't. Let's take another torch. A dungeon? What's happening? I don't know. Maybe it was a bad idea. Okay, let's move towards... That's the exit, right? Yeah. But let's check out what's here.
Warehouse.
The warehouse. Let's go down. There should be rats. There we go. Die. Let's do a fireball. It resisted. Oh no! Nothing here. Warehouse. Oh, boots. Nice. I don't hit it. Why do I not? Maybe the shoes are in the way. Soldier boots. These standard issue boots reduce the damage from attacks aimed at your feet. They increase your armory by 2. Now, I have to say I like the concept of having different target zones. Let's shoot. It resisted. Aha, there we go. Okay, I sort them like health, stamina, mana, like here. Okay, this will open the door most likely. So let's check this first. Another healing potion, and this is where all the rats are. Yes. Oh, it's flying too high. Oh. Okay, that's easy. I wonder. What happens if I move them here? The fireball doesn't really fly lower, does it? But I killed the rats. Hello, my friend. Oh, I like the magic. We need to put more stats into magic. Oh. Okay, we possibly need to put something on there to open this door. Shall we just try with the torch? Didn't do anything at all. light? Hmm. Possibly there's another solution to open this door. Oh, oh. It's getting dark. Is it burned out? Only... It's only useful as a weight or a weapon now. It can still deal some damage. Okay, we keep it though. Okay, I want to see something. So we can put it on the floor, if need be. Oh, oh, oh. Retreat. Goodbye. And once it's at our melee skill increased. So we just... It's kind of learning by doing. Large stone, can we take them? We can. Maybe we can open the door with these stones. Hmm. Oh, scroll of... Oops. Scroll of healing. Okay, we don't have what we need, but maybe it's here. It is indeed. Heart and, yeah. I think it was well worth going down here to the warehouse. Ah, there's a sign here as well.
Gate 2 opens automatically for large cargo.
Uh-huh, for large cargo deliveries. Just like large stones. Yes, two large stones do the trick. Interesting. That's a very nice gameplay mechanic. Miss. Miss. I'm not pleased. Hit. Maybe I should move things around a little. There's a button. I don't want to press it just yet. Oh, nice. Soldier's pants. These common pants reduce the damage from attacks aimed at your legs. They increase your armory by 3. And maybe there's a chest armor? No. Go up, please. Yeah. If I go on this, and for a second, it actually clicks through, so that's good. Okay. Let's press the button. We closed the door. Is there another door here? No. You know, like a secret door that opens at the same time or something. I think we should take the large stones. They might come in handy. Okay. Now let's go up. Use the key. I think it will help us a lot that we've got this additional equipment and also the healing spell. Okay, there's another.
Captain Drake's office.
Oh, Captain Drake. Is there something behind this? No. And this is locked. Presumably the exit. We're still in chapter 2, prison, underground floor 1. Okay, this is possibly Drake.
Look who's made it out of his cell. Oh, I'm glad.
I'll take a screenshot.
I rarely get the chance to fight anyone down here, and the precious Araxian steel of my blade thirsts for blood.
Yeah, but I hope it won't be my blood.
This is the part where you let me pass and hope that I don't come back for you after I'm done with Watrys.
Ah! Brave words for a dead man.
Oh. The This guy is well equipped. I don't see where I'm going to. But you know, you always got a sense of orientation with the tile system, so that's really good. He resisted. Not very good. Oh, I don't have mana. Not good. Ha. Huh. Now take this. Feel my wrath. Okay, I've got some mana. Luckily I can kind of escape through the whole dungeon. Oh, oh, oh! It's like dancing. Hello, my dear. Oh no. It's getting hot down here. But not for him. I can actually not release the mouse button to hold off the attack. Only when I release the mouse button. Okay, I can do the special attack, I think. No, I cannot anymore. Okay, that was close. Nearly died. Oh, necklace of strength. This silver necklace increases your strength by 2. That's very nice. Now where do we have to go to? This way, this way, this way. I believe this way? I've actually forgotten. Huh.
Cellar.
No. I'd like to see a larger map. Press M maybe? No. Me this way. Okay, this is the key for there, I guess. Or here. Anything here? No. Aha! Another key. Okay, this goes down here. Oh, let's just open the equipment. Scrolls are not that needed. Remove all items at once, yes, by holding the shift key. Okay, now, oops. There we go. Can I destroy this? No, apparently not. Minor mana potion. I'll take that. Don't know if there's anything with the books. We might have to destroy. But we can't. Okay, possibly there's nothing. Oh, there's another torch. We need the torch. Should not forget the torches. Let's see if we can open. Yes, we can. It says armory. Oh, nice. Let's first go here. There's the soldier's armor. This standard issue soldier armor. Soldier's armor increases your armor by 6. Okay. It doesn't change how I look, but yeah. That's not really necessary. Doesn't help the gameplay. Anyway, so it's okay. Now we've got this key. It's good that the keys we've used up did kind of disappear or stay in the keylog, so we don't carry around lots of keys we don't need anymore. Okay, there's one guard. I think it's only one.
Sound the alarm! The prisoner is escaping! Close the tower gate!
Okay, let's see what's below once I'm done with you.
He moved cleverly. Spellcasting leveled up, that's good. Take this. Melee skill leveled up. And take this. I think I might actually go for like a mixed character. Is there something here now? Can I kill him through Yes, I can theoretically. How can I open it? Okay, this is possibly like the exit. Okay. This is not ranged. But the spells are. One more and this guy is dead. We have unspent attribute points. Let's spend them while we are recharged. Oh, we've nearly recharged. Let's shoot first. Okay, let's improve intelligence. And... huh. Dexterity and intelligence. Jack of all trades, master of none. Don't know how viable that is in this game. Oh, it's getting dark. Too dark for my taste. Chapter 2 prison, the one that can be enemies killed. 17 or 7 secrets discovered, 0. Take a screenshot, proceed to next level, yes. Let's take a sneak peek into that level as well.
While our hero continues his journey towards Watrys, let me tell you how a new age begins. It begins as a blue glint in the darkness, deep within a closed Talia mine. It begins with the hands of a simple villager that keeps digging when others have stopped. If it were not for him, these crystals would have remained a myth. There would not have been any unfortunate accidents, no unexplained disappearances, no nightmarish creatures summoned into this world by ignorant fools playing with toys not meant for them. There would not have been an age of fear.
I can imagine how the touchpad is used for, you know, attacking. I think it's actually very good for 3DS. Okay, it's just one foe. We can deal with him swiftly and painfully. Yeah, I like the combination. The spell is still on, you know, countdown or cooldown. But we attack with the dagger. Our mighty, rusty dagger. It's just a shame. Oh, it's about to break. Not good. That the guy didn't lose his spear. There's a stone. Locked. Let's take the torch. I don't want to fight with the torch anymore. Let's take a look at the map. We do have a stone.
Attention, dangerous creatures.
Okay, thanks for the heads up. Can we destroy it? Yes, we can. Okay, looks like spiders. Okay, it's not for attacking apparently. We must not go down here. Or we most likely die. Oh, they are tough. Take the sword. Oh no. Go away. I don't like spiders. Okay, they don't attack diagonally. That's good for us, so we can actually dance. Dance. Oh, there's another spider. We don't have mana. It looks very nasty. It doesn't deal too much damage though. Miss. Hit. Okay, we need to use all means at hand. Our special attack? And one more. There we go. That must have given us lots of XP. But one thing it did give us, indeed, stamina potion, and that is a mighty sword. A golden sword, an ornate sword that deals 11 to 18 physical damage per 18 stamina. But I want to use it against tough opponents, because this is about to break, I guess. Oh no, it's actually just showing us what we're wearing. So items apparently don't break. So we can also use our amazing sword. Let's see, how does it change? 443? 455. That's good damage. Oh no. Die. Okay, we've killed it. Let's take a look at the map. Okay, let's go this way. Let's not step into this trap. There's yet another trap. This is something we can pull, and something else we can pull, and something else we can pull, and I'm not sure if it's smart. I get the feeling we remove the traps. Yeah, we do. Oh, it resisted. Don't do that to me. I'm cornered. Okay. And this thing is dead. This is locked somehow. Don't see any way to open it just yet, or maybe never. Oh, I was too slow. Go back. Oh no. Okay. Blocked. Oh. Nice. The combat is less stressful than I thought. You know, I thought real-time combat, ooh, not sure about that. Well, we can't go there yet. Something we can do in this area? No. This is still down. Do it like this. Still down. And like this. It's still down. Okay. But we can go this way. In the north. Yes. No, we can't. Something somewhere that I have not seen yet. I don't know. I can't really look down there, so I think if I walk, I die. Which might then conclude the episode. Can we maybe, just maybe, open that? No, apparently not. There really is nothing that indicates what we could do here. Could move left and I fall. Let's see where we... Okay. Floor 3. I think we've been on floor 1 before. Okay. There's a button. And the door goes down again. Did I see that correctly? Interesting. So there's a secret passage. Yeah, well, let's take this shortcut. If it is one, it's maybe not. Oh no, it's not. It's just for when we fall down, so we can go up again and still be stuck. Let's track back. There's a spider here. How did it get here? I think we definitely need to... Oh no, there's another path. Okay. We can open... can open possibly this one, yes. And then we still can't get through. I don't see any buttons. Don't know how we can get there. Is there maybe something? No. Just this one. Let's do it like this. Maybe if we move this, it opens, yes. Okay. Where's the guy? Oh no, there he is. I don't like you. Please die. Oh no. Please don't kill me. Please die. Please die. Please die. I think the armor that we've got really helps, and we get an iron key. Good. I'm placed. Okay, let's take the torch. I think the iron key is possibly for here. Okay, but let's check this out first. Silver key. Okay. Good. Lots of keys. There's a torch missing here. Let's put a torch here, but nothing happens. Okay, there's a...
Ask the guard for the secure...
Ask the guard. I don't think it's necessary to have the torch here.
Ask the guard.
Yeah, but the guard.
Ask the guard.
Possibly won't tell me the security key. Can I actually talk to guards? Does the torch here help? Not necessarily. Well, maybe one torch. Maybe if all three are lit, then we need the security key. Possibly there's like a vault or something. I've killed the guards. Oh, Mini went up. And we've got the buckler, which we can use instead of... Instead of... the torch. Don't know if I like that. In a fight, maybe. Iron helmet I do like.
Do not give the security code to unauthorized personnel.
Yeah, well, I'm not authorized, and there are no live living guards left. So, I don't think I can get the code. I will possibly pass on that secret. Okay, here it goes down. I think. Oh no, is this where we started? Floor 2, floor 1. But we do have keys. Okay, we need to put something here. And this will be a burnt torch. It's not enough. Second burnt torch. Not a flying torch, please. No. But we do have some of those large stones left, don't we? Do we not? No, we do. Let's move all. Now let's move just one, two. Oh no, one. Why are they flying? Oh, that's really annoying. Skeleton? No.
You're free to go. You can either leave now or wait while I clear a path to the entrance, if I live that long.
We can't talk to him, but we've freed the child. Let's talk to him.
Thank you. But there's also her brother, little Nathaniel. He's hiding somewhere near the spiders. He tried to escape some time ago. You have to save him too, please.
Yeah. Well, I won't, because we can't get past. Don't know where this other key leads to. Unspent attribute points. Let's go one strength, one here, one here. Take a look down here. Oh, there are more spiders. It's a really big spider. Look at this. What do we have here? Stamina potion, mana potion, What do we have here? It's locked. Can we use this key? Yes, we can. Okay, now we know what the key was for. How does it... This spell launches a bolt of frost at your enemies, causing 15 to 30 cold damage. And this one is 15 to 25. So this is better. Let's just change it so we can quickly change it. A torch. Now let's try our new spell. I can't. Oh yeah, obviously I can't. It needs to be like this. Nice. How much does it do here now? 6, 2, 1. Mm-hmm. 6, 4, 5. No. Okay. It's dead. I think this over there might be a pressure plate. It is. And we get a silver ring. Now that's the first. This ring was made of silver and reduces any acid damage inflicted on you by 25%. My guess is that spiders do acid damage. Cool. And you can fall down on this as well. Okay. But it doesn't continue here. So we still need to figure out how to get past those spiders. But I will figure that out on my own. I think that will conclude the episode with this success. I think we'll see it, yeah. So thanks a lot for watching. Don't know what you think of the game. I mean it's not stunningly beautiful, but it's effective, and I like the system of mixing the runes, dragging around your mouse, also doing like those different attacks. It's not too stressful. You can always kind of move back and kind of retreat from an opponent, and then do your attacks. Very nice game. Might be worth getting on the 3DS as well. I don't know the differences between the two versions, apart from graphics and input control. But yeah. Thanks a lot for watching. Until then, bye for now.